Welcome to video lecture series on subject surveying. Today we learn the topic forbearing, local attraction, magnetic declination. In previous lecture we see the what is mean by bearing, types of the bearing, okay, forbearing and back bearing. So bearing is nothing but it is the horizontal angles made with the reference meridian and the survey line. So we have generally taken the reference meridian is the north, that is magnetic north. So bearing is nothing but the horizontal angle between the magnetic north to the survey line, it is called as bearing. Then we see the forbearing and back bearing. So what is mean by forbearing? The forbearing is nothing but the bearings which are measured in the direction of progressive survey. So here the direction of the progressive survey, this direction, so that's why the forbearing of AB, if I return the forbearing of AB is theta here, okay. Similarly back bearing is, we have to define as the back bearing is the bearings which are measured in opposite direction of the survey. So this is the direction of the survey, so opposite direction is this for this AB line, so opposite direction is this, so the back bearing is, this is the your back bearing. So back bearing of AB is theta 1. So I have written here forbearing of line AB, okay. So forbearing of line AB is what is theta, okay. So forbearing of line AB is theta, so which are measured from the station A. So this is the forbearing of line measured with respect to station A, this is station B, okay. Similarly back bearing, back bearing of line, same line, back bearing of line AB, don't write BA. So back bearing of line AB is theta 1, so this is the back bearing of line theta 1, okay. So this is theta 1, so back bearing which is measured from the B station, and forbearing here you have to measure from the A station. Remember that forbearing you have to measure from this A station, and back bearing is measured from the B station, okay. Then if the direction of the survey is in this way, so just let us see, okay. This is the direction of the our survey, okay. So A to B, here is not A to B, here from B to A, so forbearing is from B to A, because direction is this, this is not direction our, so this is our direction is this, so direction is B to A, so the forbearing of BA, not AB, this is the major from the north to the survey line, this is your forbearing, and back bearing is, that is theta, and back bearing of same line BA is major from the north to that survey line is theta 1. So in the direction of the survey, so we have to remember that we called as forbearing, and opposite direction of the survey it is called as back bearing, okay. Then just okay, let us see in this figure, you have to better understand, okay. Let A B C D, this is a closed traverse, A B C D and A, so this is a closed traverse, okay. So as we know the closed traverse, first point and last points are connected, traverse is nothing but the series of connected lines, so here the traverse are connected, A B C D is the closed traverse. In that, what is the forbearing of line AB? Forbearing of line AB is this, okay, this is your, okay, this is your forbearing of line AB is, this is the forbearing of line AB is, then what is the back bearing of AB? So back bearing of line AB, so you have to measure from the north to the survey line, this is your back bearing, so I have written here 2. Okay. Then forbearing of BC. So you have to measure from B toward the BC line. So this is the your forbearing of BC. What is the back bearing of BC? So you have to measure from the C station toward the BC line. So if I taken this is our north to the survey line, this is the BC line. So back bearing of BC is from the this C station toward the survey line. That is the back bearing of what? BC. Then what is the forbearing of CD? Forbearing of CD is, so you have to measure from the C station toward the CD line. So if I draw, so this just I change the color. Okay, so this is what? Forbearing of what? C to D line. Okay, then what is the back bearing of CD? So you have to measure from the D station toward the CD line. I think you have to understand. Similarly, what is the forbearing of DA? So measure from the D towards the DA line. Okay, and back bearing of DA line, not AD line. Back bearing of DA line is measure from the A towards that DA line. So I think you have to better understand what is forbearing and back bearing. Then some example we have to see. As we know that the difference between the forbearing and back bearing is exactly 180 degree. So forbearing is equal to back bearing plus or minus 180 degree, or back bearing is equal to forbearing plus or minus 180 degree. It means when you have to find out the if the bearing of a line, for example, just we see back bearing. Okay, so we have to see the some example. The forbearing of line is given, find out the back bearing. So what is the forbearing of line AB? 310 degree 30 minutes. So this value is more than what? 180 degree. So you have to what is the back bearing? So back bearing is equal to forbearing plus or minus 180 degree. So when we have to use the plus or when we have to minus, here this value is more than 180 degree. So you have to add, so you have to subtract. Okay, you have to subtract from 180. Okay, so 310 degree 30 minutes minus 180, to get answer. Here value is less than, this value is less than this value is less than 180 degree. So you can, here the value is less than 180 degree, so you have to add 145 degree 50 minutes. So you can see here. Okay, you can see here directly. Okay, so that's why 145 degree plus 180 degree, another value is 210. That's why you have to subtract 180 degree. The answer get 30 degree 30 minutes. Here the value is less than 180 degree, so that's why you have to add. So just remember, forbearing is equal to back bearing plus or minus 180 degree. Okay, I think you have to understand. Then local attraction. So local attraction is nothing but, sorry, when the needle, when the prismatic compass, or when the needle is, when the prismatic compass is set or station, when the needle is freely suspended and when it is properly balanced, will show the magnetic north. Okay, however, when the compass is set nearly iron or steel structure under the cable carrying electrical current, such as the magnetic needles of the compass does not shows the exactly magnetic north. This deviation or the needles is deflected from that normal position. Okay, so this deviation of the needles is called as local attraction. So what is meant by local attraction? A local attraction is nothing but when the needle is freely suspended, which show the north direction, but due to the some electrical poles, steel tank, lamp, post or iron near the surrounding area, that needle is may be deflected. That deviation of the needles is called as local attraction. Okay, so what happened? when the needle is deflected. So you have to not get the readings correctly. It means, for example, if I take the line AB, forebearing of line AB is 30 degree. So what is the back bearing of line AB? So 30 plus 180 degree. Okay, you know that 30 plus 180 degree nothing but 210 degree is the back bearing of line AB. But what happened? Due to the local attraction, you have to not get the readings exactly 30 degree or 210 degree. So here you have to get reading 29 degree 30 minutes or more than 210 degree. So how you can calculate the local attraction? So when the in any line forebearing and back bearing difference doesn't come exactly 180 degree, at that condition you have to called as in that line there is a local attraction. Okay, so we can see here how you have to calculate the local attraction. So there is a method one calculation of the local attraction. Okay, calculation of local attraction. In this method, first the difference of the forebearing and back bearing, first we have to check. We already know that the difference between the forebearing and back bearing of line will be 180 degree. If there is no error in that, there is no local attraction. If there is error, so there is a local attraction in that line. So based on this error, free observation of the bearing, correction for other line can be calculated. If the observed bearing is less than corrected bearing, the error is negative and the correction to the observed bearing will be positive, and vice versa. So this is the first methods. Then in case of the second method, this method is more faster than applying the correction. So let us example, as we know that let ABC is the triangles, just I draw one triangles. So let this is our triangle. Okay, so what is the addition of these triangles? As we know that the addition comes exactly 180 degree, but this angle is 60 degree, this angle is 60 degree, or this angle is, we have to take this just example 60 degree. So first you have to find out the interior angles of all these angles by using the observed bearing. Nothing but we know that the forebearing of AB, back bearing of AB, forebearing of BC, back bearing of BC, forebearing of CD, back bearing of CD. In then you have to find out the angle A, angle B, and angle C. Then you have to add this all the angles and check whether the addition comes are exactly 180 degree or not. If the angles addition is not comes exactly degree, then for example addition comes 180 degree, so 1 degree is extra. So you have to 1 degree divided by angles 3, 20 second we have to subtract in each angles. For example, if your addition of angles comes 179 degree, so we have to what? 1 degree is less. So you have to 1 degree divided by 3 number of angles, that is 20 second you have to add in each angles, then you have to find out the corrected forebearing and back bearing. So this is the methods. So for the interior angles, for example, let us see these figures. Okay, in this figure, so ABC it is a traverse. So what is the addition of the all the angles, angle A, angle B, angle C, and angle D? Here the addition of all the angles is 360 degree. So how I calculated 360 degree? So formula is for interior angles 2n, okay, 2n minus 4 into 90. Okay, 2n minus 4 into 90. So what is n? N is the number of the station. So 4 into 4 into 2, 8 minus 4, 4 into 90, 360. So interior angles, all the interior angle must become 360 degrees. Similarly, this is the interior angle, you can find out the exterior angles. Just in case of the exterior angles, you have to 2n plus 4. Okay, so you can find out the exterior angles by using 2n plus 4 into the right angle, that is 90. So in this formula, you have to calculate interior as well as exterior angles. So by using these methods, you can find out the corrected forebearing and back bearing. Okay. Just I erase this. Okay. Before that, magnetic declinations. What is mean by magnetic declination? The horizontal angle between the magnetic north and the true north. Okay. The horizontal angle between the magnetic north and the true north is known as magnetic declination. So you can see the figures. So in these figures, the magnetic declination towards the east, because when the north end of the magnetic needles is pointed towards the east side of the true meridian, this is we called as declination towards the, when the declination towards the east side, it is called as declination towards the east declination. When the declination towards the west side, it is called as declination towards the west. So declination varies from place to place and at any station from time to time. So the true bearing of a line is equal to a magnetic bearing of a line plus minus declination. This is the formula. When the magnetic bearing is given, you can find out the true bearing, and when the declination is given, you can find out the true bearing. So when the declination true bearing of a line is equal to magnetic bearing of a line plus minus declination. So use the positive sign when the declination toward the east, use the negative sign when the declination toward the west. Okay, so here toward the west. Okay, then isogonic line. These are the line joining obtained by joining the points at which magnetic declination is same at the given time. Agonic line. These are the lines obtained by connecting the points at which the magnetic declination is zero. Dip. Due to the magnetic influence of the earth, the needles after magnetization will not remain in horizontal position, but it will be inclined towards the pole. This declination of the needles with the horizontal is called as the dip of the needles. The dip is not constant, but varies from place to place on the surface of the earth. It will be 0 degree at equator and 90 degree at the magnetic poles. So what is mean by isogonic? The line joining the points which have magnetic declination is the same or equal. Agonic line, these are the line obtaining the points which of magnetic declination is 0. Just you remember, magnetic declination is same, it is isogonic. Magnetic declination is 0, it is agonic line. Okay, so this is the that needle is deflected. Okay, then problems related to the magnetic declination. The magnetic bearing of a line is given 135 degree 30 minutes. What will be the true bearings if the declination is 5 degree 15 minutes west? So magnetic bearing is given, declination is also given. So as we know that true bearing is equal to magnetic bearing of a line plus magnetic declination. Plus sign is used when declination towards the east, minus sign is used when the declination towards the west. So here the declination towards the west is W, is that symbol, you remember that the symbol, that declination 5 degree 15 degrees west, W, that is west symbol related to the toward the west. Okay, so true bearing is equal to magnetic bearing minus declination. You have to get the true bearing. Okay, then similarly, the true bearing of a line CD is given, and what is the magnetic bearing of a line? What will be the magnetic bearing of line? Here the previous problem, you have to find out the true bearing, but here you have to find out the magnetic bearing. So magnetic bearing is equal to true bearing plus declination, because the formula was what? ट्रू बेरिंग इज इक्वल टू मैग्नेटिक बेरिंग प्लस माइनस डिक्लिनेशन. हियर द डिक्लिनेशन इज गिवन वेस्ट. सो मैग्नेटिक बेरिंग इज इक्वल टू ट्रू बेरिंग प्लस डिक्लिनेशन इज कम्स. दैट्स वाई द वैल्यू इज कम 219 डिग्री. ओके सो थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. इफ यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम्स और डाउट्स वी हैव टू लेट अस इन वी हैव टू सॉल्व योर डाउट्स इन डिस्कशन सेक्शन. ओके थैंक यू.